Hello everyone, today I'm here with another video for you, and unfortunately I failed on recording some of my previous games, so today you can see a rating leap, but I cannot do anything about it, so let's just play another instructive rated game. So today we have a 1900 rated opponent. I think it can be interesting. And I'm playing with white pieces, and he aborted our game. Okay. Maybe he just doesn't want to play with 1800. And now this opponent is around our rating, and again e4 e5 and Spanish game. So well, so far we're playing normal moves, just developing, and here let's just play bishop to d7. And I think maybe I'll play this plan. As white, I would play here, for example, rook to e1, yeah, or d4, it is also possible. Here, if we do nothing about this, I think he's gonna play d5, and yeah, but maybe we'll manage to trap him if we play b5, goes here, we take it, he takes it, we take, then he takes, if he takes with his queen, then we play c5, and then c4, completely blocking his bishop, and then taking it. So let's just take it with the pawn. But also, if he takes with his queen here, then we'll be attacking our rook. I didn't see it. It's not so good. But anyway, let's play this. We can give up on our plan and just play bishop to g7, creating a double attack here, but he decided to take. And he attacks our rook immediately. What can we do here? We can play queen to f6, proposing this exchange. This will be even good for us. Or just play knight to f6. But to free up this side of the board, I prefer to play queen to f6. Not to complicate our game even more. Maybe bishop g7 next, if he moves away his queen somewhere. But he takes, okay, g7 to castle on our next move. But now we have also this double attack, but it's a bad idea to take because rook e1 will pin our piece. Doesn't matter which one we take with. And then f3, and our piece will be lost. So we castle first, then we can pretend to take this pawn, but not right now. If he is threatened to take our knight, you know, it's a bad exchange, bad for a knight, because I'll continue to play with two bishops, and it's always good. This is not a closed position, it's closer to an open one, so two bishops here are very powerful. But I decided to castle. Maybe h6, just driving away his bishop next. I don't know where. Oh. Bishop to d5. So if I take with my knight, then knight takes, attacking this pawn. And if I take with my bishop, again knight takes, but then I can take this knight. This pawn will be weak, I suppose, and we're threatening b2 immediately, and if we take and he takes with a pawn, we can just drive his knight away and take this pawn. In Spanish games, white square bishop is powerful, so if we manage to exchange it, it's not bad for black, I suppose. Yeah, he takes with the pawn. Now we can play b4, no matter where he moves to. Yeah, of course he can take our knight, but it's good for us to have a bishop here. Let's play this. And we remove this move, and now we can just take this pawn. So we're a pawn up already. Now we have to decide where to move. I think a3 is saving our pawn, but our bishop becomes not really well placed, and moving somewhere away will just give him back a pawn. So we go here, and it takes, we take, and maybe rook to b3, threatening this pawn, and we'll lose it also. So I think if we play bishop to c3, if he takes, we'll take, then we're at least opening up this file. And if he takes our pawn, we can put our rook on b8, and then maybe to b2, and rook on 7th file is quite okay for us. And first we'll apply another open file here. This pawn is hanging though, but do we really need to protect it? not sure, but just not to lose material, I can protect it for now. So he decided to attack another pawn. If we play rook to e2, threatening this pawn, so if we take this, we take this. Maybe it's not a bad idea. And if he, for example, doesn't take, we can even play rook to d2, attacking this pawn, and it's unprotectable. So yeah. So we can just threaten to checkmate him or exchange his rooks, but I don't think that is good for us, because I'm quite sure he'll notice this threat easily. And let's just take that pawn instead. Yeah, we could play, of course we could play five first, but anyway, I don't think it would change much. And now to play, for example, rook to a5, threatening this pawn, he can protect it. Playing this, well, so far it looks just a drawish endgame, but at least my king is more safe with this. To a7, protecting this pawn, to unleash this rook somewhere, and I don't think that's a bad idea, but maybe first we can push our pawns. I don't know, I like flex position better, but I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to do now. Okay, let's play rook to a7. Maybe rook to a8 next, or rook to e8. Maybe f5 and going with our king to the center. Yeah, let's play this. Now we can play e8 with a check, so let's not waste this opportunity. My king here, for example, it's a good central square. You can play, of course, you can play rook to e1 now, exchanging my rooks with these two rooks, but as you know, it's really good for him. Maybe it is actually because this king will stay will be in the center, while my king will be on the 3rd rank, but it's impossible. We decided to push this A5 pawn, but I don't think we'll succeed on this. And play c5 to get rid of this weak pawn, and our rook will be kind of unleashed, and we can even play a rook to a8, create a double attack, making his rook move to a4. But okay, here just h4, and we have no problem with these three pawns. And I'm again low on time. It's not a really frequent thing for me, but I think it's because I'm explaining. Usually I tend to make quick moves. Sometimes it plays so we can just place our king here, and this rook, or this pawn, I'm sorry, will fall, I suppose. But the king here, then just this, and this rook is not able to support this pawn anymore. Also, if king goes here, we can just check, and he will have to retreat. And well, maybe if he plays king to c4, we can even drive our rook onto second frame. Okay, let's let's take this pawn. If we exchange our rooks here, and our king will stay here, and it will be a pawn endgame, will we manage to queen any of these two pawns? I don't even know, but let's try anyway. I think that they're all my pawns are far from their initial positions, and these pawns are still staying there. So yeah, let's make a check, then play king to b6. Okay, let's retreat. If he returns his rook to a1, then well, that's not really good, because if I play here, and it will give me another check, and this pawn is still under his control. But no, yeah, he couldn't do this because I just take. So can I just take? I think yes. And check here. let's just grab this pawn to be a pawn up. It's not bad. He's trying to win this pawn, but I don't think he managed to do this. So we can just protect it, but or we can just give another check just to have some fun. This king is trying to get to that pawn. We're running out of time. So okay, let's just protect it and protect this pawn like that. Next we'll have to decide something on this pawn. We'll definitely need to move our king. And maybe this maneuver and our king will go to these pawns to support them somehow. Now even rook to a2 is okay, threatening this pawn, but he decided to exchange our pawns. Let's do it. And I don't know how to push this pawn further, but maybe we can propose him to exchange, but then we take this pawn will fail, and they're equally far away, so not sure it's a winning strategy for us. So okay, well, let's save this file anyway. Not file, this blank. Maybe we can give him a check. I don't know what for, but what we can. So here, check here. Maybe now he'll just try to win on time, giving me some checks. Let's return here. I'm trying to push my pawns as far away as I can. And here, check, here, takes, that's okay. I think if he takes, it's better to take without king, not to exchange all of my rooks. And can I just play? Yeah, I think I can play c4, maybe even d3 next, exchanging our rooks at last, and then supporting this pawn to come out to a queen. Yeah, he defends. Let's give him this check. Maybe. I don't know. Rook here, okay. Letting this pawn looks quite good. And freeing this square for our pawn. Let's propose an exchange here. He refuses, okay. Then let's play this. Maybe check now. And this. Okay, we're two pawns up. I think one of them, at least one of them, can promote here. If I do not make any bad decisions because of time issues, then I have to win this game. Let's exchange here, even losing this pawn. This is really far promoted. And his king is not able to prevent this promotion to get close to this pawn, because this file is controlled with our rook. Let's play here. So yeah, we managed to promote our pawn and he resigned. Reasonable action here, because take and the endgame with rook against lonely king is winning. Oh no, I don't want to play another game. It was occasional click. I just want to analyze this game. Do the games and this one. So that was this Spanish game, and Morphy defends again. It's quite popular, yeah. It's no wonder we play it for the second time in three games, because this opening is really popular on both beginner and intermediate level. I suppose that at advanced level as well. So let's just run through our moves and check if we takes. So here the computer suggests that we play bishop g7 and now c1 because there is no that trap available after queen g6 because queen from here attacks this rook. So this was a mistake given our white some chances right from the opening. But we didn't take it, so here we have even chances again. So here I should have taken with my knight, then he takes with his pawn, I take here, and he takes here and here, but I suppose that after taking, he would just take with his knight with the same result after this. But maybe not the same because I played this. Okay, b4 was not really a good move because this pawn became hanging, and he managed to regain material because of this. So here I didn't use my chances, and here as well, so I needed to play this, and okay, with this, just threatening this pawn, exchanging and doubling my pawns, okay, looks a bit strange, but this is a computer and he thinks in other ways that I do. So here I took, he played rook to b1, and this was suggested move here, but this bishop looks really refrained here, so I didn't choose this move. Here he takes, I take, rook here, takes, protect. So yeah, it is a completely trollish endgame. Without any mistakes, just position equal to zero. So yeah, this was a strange move, giving up this pawn. And it gave me a real chances. And here, this was the check for fun, and it really lost our advantage. So here I needed just to return my rook, but I lost some tempi, and his king got really close to my pawns. So That was not a good decision of me. So just normal moves here, and this pawn exchange was not really reasonable because he had less pawns than me, and exchange is three two strong pawns, and without any real attack or promoting chances, it's not good. So here it is equal again. I need to push my pawn, but I decided another strategy. And he allowed me to double my rooks here attacking this pawn. This was his mistake. Okay, so here it is completely winning for black. So I'm just wondering how many mistakes I made. And thank you for watching. I hope that it was useful for you. This opening is quite popular, as I said before, and you can take some ideas from me how to play it, at least on at the intermediate level. And I made 4 blunders, 1 mistake. Not really good, but anyway, the most important thing is that I won the game. So thank you for watching, stay tuned, and goodbye.